rooibos tea, black sugar levels, dogs. Did you hear what I just said? Tea, sugar, dog. Zaria, what's going on? Come and tell us. Come and talk to us about it. Come through, my dear. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for a young scientist in the making. Come through. You are as short as I am, so let's hope you can also stand on this side. Who's taller? Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Today I'd like to tell you about my science project on rooibos tea. It all started one Easter when our Labrador dog, Jessie, decided to join the Easter egg hunt uninvitedly. She was delighted when she found a nice, big, juicy Easter egg under one of her favorite lounging bushes. She gobbled it up, wrapper and all, before anyone else could ever say it. Soon after that, we started to notice that she was walking into things more and more, and that her eyes had gone cloudy. She also experienced a sudden weight loss, was drinking a lot more water, and was lacking energy. We took her to the vet who diagnosed her with diabetes. This was a shock for us and was very sad because we didn't expect it. Managing Jessie's diabetes. Jessie needed a routine for her food and insulin, as well as regular blood checks and regular exercise to keep her healthy and happy. How the project came together. We found the cost of the insulin very high, which is why many people have to put down their dogs when they are diagnosed with diabetes. But then one day we heard a lady on the radio saying that she had diabetes and that she used rooibos tea to control it. We decided, why not try this as a science project? Our visit to the vet. We took this idea to the vet, who confirmed that it was safe to give rooibos tea to dogs. She also told us that it was used in some skin and eye care products for dogs, and suggested a questionnaire around the awareness of diabetes in dogs and cats. Our research. Like any good 21st century researcher, standard or professional, we turned to Google. We also contacted Dr. Al Joubert from the Agricultural Research Center. He told us that this type of research had never been done before in dogs, although it had been done before in humans, rats, and monkeys, and had been proven successful. She suggested that we use green rooibos tea instead of normal rooibos tea because it had better health benefits. And we met a man in the park who told us that he had diabetes and his doctor gave him a schedule for drinking rooibos tea. Finding the dogs for this project. We visited 5 vets, talked to people in dog parks, and asked on social media to find diabetic dogs to help us with this project. We found it surprisingly hard to find willing owners to help with this project, because the rooibos can't harm the dogs in any way. Overall, we found 9 diabetic dogs, although only 3 were willing participants, and that includes Jessie. Jekyll's Tea Packers. We hope to get a better outcome of diabetic dogs to help us with this project, and so we contacted Jekyll's Tea Packers to sponsor the green rooibos tea for this project. Not only did they do this, but they also sponsored the sample teas for the owners as a thank you, as well as now in 2017, since my project has been so popular on social media sites, they are sponsoring a donation on Facebook for Wetnose, where every time this ad is shared, it donates 2 rand to Wetnose. The questionnaire. We used a monkey survey to find out how many people were aware that dogs and cats can get diabetes, and how much they understood about its symptoms and prevention. Our results were that out of a sample group of 100 people, which were majority school parents, roughly 24% were not aware that dogs and cats can get diagnosed with diabetes. We expected more to not be aware though, because when talking to people, we got the idea that very few actually did understand this. The aim of the project. Our aim of the project was to find out if greenery with tea can help to stabilize a diabetic dog's blood sugar levels. Conducting the tests. Step one is a step that I'm sure many of you do almost every day. We made a normal cup of tea, although this cup of tea was green robust tea, and it had no milk or sugar in it. Step two was very simple. We put it into the dog's drinking bowl, along with 4 cups of normal tap water. And we left the dog to drink it throughout the day with their own will. We found that they enjoyed the robust tea and didn't mind drinking it. We would refresh the solution at least once a day. We also took blood tests at the start of this testing, as well as every 2 weeks into it, to keep track of how their blood sugar levels were being influenced. This was done over the period of a month. During the testing, we also kept their diets, exercise routine, and insulin the same. Difficulties in controlling dog diabetes. Dogs are natural hunters and scavengers and may find something funny to eat on the ground in outside areas or in inside areas like the kitchen. To back up the statement, while I was busy doing a radio interview and my dog JC joined us, I was busy explaining this to the interviewer as JC decided to dig under the desk into the dustbin to see what she was going to have for lunch. This is why it is so hard to control diabetes in dogs, and is one of the main reasons why we couldn't scientifically prove this project. We also found that the blood tests were not exact, as it was only a pinprick of blood, and it only took their blood at that certain time of day. So if, for example, your dog had just eaten an Easter egg, then their blood sugar levels would be a lot higher. If they had just eaten, well, JC hates the vet, so his stress levels would be higher when she goes, and then her blood sugar levels would also be higher. But if they haven't eaten in quite a while, then their blood sugar levels will be a lot lower. Limitations to the project. We struggled to find diabetic dogs to help us with this project and ended up with only 3. We also ended up with only 1 month to do the testing of this project. And we only used a pinprick of blood for the blood test, so it wasn't very exact. The conclusion to this project. This method appears to work and to make a difference to the dog's blood glucose levels, although we could not scientifically prove it and would need further research. I would enjoy to see this research being done, and I would like to see what the results would be. But now for our burning question. What is making so many innocent dogs fall victim to diabetes? Is it perhaps something that we give our dogs in their commercial dog food? Or is it because of their lack of exercise, because you're running out of time for them? Feedback from my project. One of the diabetic dog owners that we interviewed for this project mentioned that he had diabetes himself, and after the interview, he decided to try green robust tea. He reported that he felt a lot better after drinking it, and if his blood sugar levels were high, he'd feel nauseous. Although after drinking it, it'd feel almost completely normal again. And if he went to a restaurant and ordered a bit of dessert, he'd simply drink a cup of green rooibos tea along with it to keep the symptoms away of him feeling bad. Thank you for listening to my presentation. This has been a huge opportunity for me. I hope that I can influence at least one of you to go home and take your furry friends for a walk, or at least give them some much beloved playtime.
I think I need a photo opportunity.